the disciples, they have not come into the knowledge of Jesus. They are only still struggling. They are going on talking about their failures. Oh, we wasted our time. Oh, when you move with your thought of the world, when you talk about your failures, you can't meet the Lord, though the Lord is standing on the shore of your life. And they could not recognize Jesus. Then Jesus could have made fun of them. Hello, it looks that you are all tired and you spend the whole night. Hope you got something. How much fish you got? No, he didn't want to humiliate them. He only asked them, have you got anything? With sadness they say, no. Our God, the grace of God means knowing our failure, standing with us, and to help us to come out of the failure into success. That is called the grace of God. Knowing our weakness, knowing our brokenness, knowing where we have fallen, He will stand with us to lift us up and to rise up to the great height. Though we don't deserve it. Yes. Now the Lord says, my children, look what is the address He gives them to the disobedient people. Like a politician, Peter, he went and took the whole gang along with him. And the Lord addresses them, my children. We can't change love of Christ. We may become bad to words, but the love of Christ always remains. That's why in Romans chapter 11 verse 29 it is written, the call and gift of God are irrevocable. It will never change. He has called us. There are millions of people in the world, but He has chosen you and me to be His children, to be called His own. And that is the privilege. And He will never change it. He has chosen us for a purpose. Now Jesus is telling them, put your net on the right side. Most of the time in life, we do on the wrong side. And we get into emptiness. But Jesus is there to tell us, put your net on the right side and you will get some. And when they put it on the right side, they got 153 fishes, big ones. And the nets, Bible says, did not tear, because it will never tear. When you and I carry the blessing of the Lord, our net, our life will never be broken. And they brought, bringing the fish, seeing plenty of fish. Only then John comes to realize, array, it's the Lord. Some of us realize only when miracles take place, our eyes are open to see the Lord. And another interesting thing we see is, as soon as John said, it is the Lord, Peter realizes, array, I am empty. I am without clothes. Many of the time, we are roaming around with our own world. The moment we realize the Lord is near us, the light of the knowledge of God gives us to know that we are without proper clothes. We are without proper covering. And Peter, realizing his situation, he puts on the clothes, and then the rest of the disciples reach the shore. Look at the grace of God, the sensitivity of Jesus. They reached the shore and they found, like a mother, Jesus has already prepared. My children are struggling whole night and they are not going to bring anything. And they are not going to get anything. And that they are going to be disturbed. Because their life is a failure, they are going to think. That will take away their energy. They will be hungry. So like a mother, He prepared the hot bread, the fire for them to remove their coldness and hot fish. When did Jesus go to catch the fish? Yes. What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no one imagine is the thing God does for his children. And when the disciples came, they saw Jesus never asked Peter, come, I want to talk to you. 3 times you denied me. Nothing. Jesus, who is a sensitive, he is not bothered about what we have not done, but he is bothered to tell what God wants to do for us. So Jesus asked them, have you got the breakfast? Come. Eat with me the breakfast. My dear friends, this is the love of God, which is unchanging. It is the grace of God, which cannot be understood. Let's enter into this divine mercy. Don't roam around your struggle and your weakness. Enter into the goodness of God and celebrate life. That's why the famous song we sing always, give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the holy ones. Give thanks because he has given Jesus Christ, his son. Give thanks
with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his son.
And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us.
And now, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done.
Celebrate the goodness of God. How God is so sensitive to us. Yes. I remember a small incident in the Old Testament. There was a king called Ahaz. He was not listening to God. He was not bothered about God. And then God comes and tells Ahaz, do you know how much God loves you? How much God loves mankind? He says, no, I don't want to talk about God. God never leaves him and said, do you know, God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. He saw Ahaz saying, what you are talking? Yes, my son. Do you know, God can do anything for you. Ask something which is so high like the sky, so deep like the sea. And Ahaz says, no, I will not ask. Then the Lord says, I will give you something. A young virgin will bear a son, and you will call him Emmanuel. God will be with you forever. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is the love of God. That is the goodness of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. God's love
is so wonderful. Oh, wonderful love. God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. Oh, wonderful love. So high, we can't get over it. So deep, we can't get under it. So wide, we can't get around it. Oh, wonderful love.
Do you want to know? Do you want to enter into that love? Raising your hands, worship the Lord. Oh Lord, open my eyes, open our hearts. How you are so sensitive to us, Lord. Your love is greater than the sea and the sky, Lord. Even when we go away from you, like Peter, most of the time we are insensitive to you, Lord. But you are sensitive to us. You always stand on the shore of our life, Lord. When we are crying about our failures, when our boats are empty, when we have no fishes, you always stand on the shore of our life. You feel for us, Lord, and you cry, my children, have you got anything? Nothing. You are more concerned about us than us, Lord. We always think about us. We always feel that we are helpless. We always think we are miserable. But when we are miserable, the first person to feel miserable is you, Lord. It is you who share with us, Lord. You always concern like a mother. And you ask, have you eaten breakfast? Come. Come. Lord, open our hearts to understand you. Open our hearts to understand your love and move with you as our strength. We will cross over everything, Lord. Today, what we are is by your grace. Thank you.